Hi everyone, my name is Gio. I am also known as Yahwri on YouTube or plover777 on Twitter. So today I want to do a step-by-step tutorial on how to shade a top, I guess. I know I have done many tutorials, but I haven't done a step-by-step one, so a lot of people may be confused, but I will try my best to record this video and I guess try my best to explain. Okay, first, let's drag this over here. Okay. First off, you want to find your inspo. I have found this top on my feed. It's I found this on my feed. Let me just do that to tops. I think this would be the closest one that has like detailed wrinkle-ish. But you can also find any other tops that you want. If you want like a t-shirt or anything like that, it's just it's still the same shading method. I just do like different rotation, I guess. I don't know if that makes sense. Also, disclaimer, I'm very sorry if you don't understand anything I'm saying or if I don't make sense. Sometimes, English isn't my first language and I'm not the best with it. And it's really hard to explain and I get really nervous and stuff. So, I will try my best. Okay, so I'm going to keep my inspo top over to the screen. Going to move on to krita. Okay. First thing you want to do is, of course, outline it. Let me check. Alright, first let's outline that. I usually use this mirror tool because it's a lot easier and I don't have to like drive or something. Like duplicate it because I'm very lazy. You could create the measure curve tool, whatever it's called. And I use this brush. Hold on. This basic brush. That's literally called basic. This is what it looks like. Okay. This is brush. Set it to all the way to 0. If you want a smaller brush stroke, use this one. The basic to opacity brush, and then just put it on it. And one. Yeah, like that. And you should have a better opacity brush. But I don't really like using it because I think it's like too. Use black and let's start with my outline. I will speed this up because the outline don't really important. Yeah. Also, I forgot to mention, if you want to disable the curve one, go to this color wheel over here. Click on this next one next to the advanced color selector. And then there's gonna be like an options here. And just disable, enable our automatic curve. This is what your curve would look like with automatic curve. If you disable that, it's going to be like wary, if you get what I mean. I usually enable it for my outlines. Okay. Let's get started. Okay, now that I have my outline, just fill in, I guess. Thank you. now that we're done with shading, let's add in some texturing. I personally like adding textures a lot, if you can't tell by my tweets on Twitter and all of my videos, of course. They all have textures. People keep asking me what textures I used for my designs. I use Krita designs. I mean Krita textures. If you want the textures that I use, it's all in Krita. It's literally a preset texture pack that comes with the program. Nothing else. It's literally a program that has a texture feature. That's how I got it. That's how, if you guys are curious. Okay, now that we have texture in, begin on with the shading. First of all, let's take out your white color, measure curve tool once again, and just go in. Now that you got that, you just overlay it in the lower opacity. And that's how you do it. It's just for a little extra detail. Yeah, that's it. Let's begin with the actual shading. Okay, so first let's do a simple box shading. Everybody knows box shading unless you're a beginner. What box shading is, it's just something like this. You just make a line. Use this tool if you can't make straight lines. Okay, just figure it out. What are you using? Yes. There you go, box shading is very simple. Next. Hold on. I need to move this all the way from the top. Okay. Next. Let's begin with outline shading. let's actually, before I do that, I want to do a simple outline shading first, but with a style option, I guess. So at the top, you would see a lot of these options in English, of course, or your language. You go to layers, and then you down here you'll see layer style. Click on that. Make sure you're on your outline layer. Okay. Over here is going to be a drop shadow right here. Enable that. Distance 1, spread, think around 20, and size 2 to 2 or 3. This is what I like to do. This and just adjust it to your liking. Better. There you go, adjust that to your liking. And of course, that should be it. Now you can see that there's a tiny little shading. Okay, now let's move on to the real shading. The brushes I'd like to use is this brush. It's like a soft eraser. Yeah. A soft eraser, this is my setting. Yeah, this is normally my setting. Next, we have an airbrush. I also use it for erasing, for soft erasing, of course. And this brush, this is the brush I will be using for to shade. This is what it looks like. The basic brush over here. So what we do is do it like this. Let's do an example first. Make something like that. Get the blur tool. Not too big. And just smudge it out. Then take out the soft eraser brush. Just erase the part that you want. Take out the blur tool again. Blur. Blur the edges a little so it doesn't look that sharp. And then just take the soft overall eraser. Adjust the opacity to your liking. That is the overall shading that you need to know. That's just how I shade. Now we're going to move on the real deal, the point that everyone what I'm here for. Okay, take out that brush. Let's clip it just in case. Now let's start shading. Let's go over here again to our reference. As you can see, it goes like down. It only goes down. You can see. So we're going to try and reference that into our top. Okay. I would like to do some boxes. Box this first. Like that. Take out much. Soft eraser if you leave it too dark or if it's necessary. And that should be it. And just keep doing it until you're done with your design. Play around with the brush sizes and opacity. Do whatever to your liking. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.